Hey everybody, it's Teresa coming back with my flip through on my ESV single column journaling Bible from 2016. So let's get started. Obviously, I cannot do every single page because there's just way too much in here, but I picked out some and I'm going to try to do this quickly so that we can kind of get through it. So I did books at the beginning of all the books of the Bible. It says, read God's word. It is the key to life. And then for my getting started with God creating the earth, I did the sun and the moon and the plants and the animals and the sea and the land. So I really liked that one because I love giraffes and, well, you know, and elephants and any kind of safari animals. So so I think most of you know that I'm a professional photographer and that I used to shoot weddings and own my own business, but I am retired now. So anytime I get a chance to draw cameras, I do. And so I really like this one. This was the report of the spies. So focus on God, not on the issue. He will take care of it. And that's in Numbers 13:25. This is where it starts. So my next one, I really loved this one. This is, I believe it's Deuteronomy 31:6, but it talks about the brave and being brave where Joshua to succeed Moses. So I really liked that one. This one was really cool because I really wanted to do this. This is about Joshua asking God to have the sun stand still. And I asked my daughter, I'm like, gosh, what do I do? And she's really good about coming up with ideas to draw. And she'll tell you, I can't draw anything, but she can come up with great ideas. And so I did a pocket watch and the sun and the moon. And some of it is watercolor and some of it is pencil. So, and then next is, this is the one that says, for me and my house will serve the Lord, but I did, as for me and my tribe, we will serve the Lord, because I have a lot of Choctaw and Cherokee Indian in me. So I love teepees and arrows and things like that. So I think I might have passed up one that I did. Maybe not. This one was cool. It's just an arrow. And it says, the angel of the Lord appeared to him and said to him, the Lord is with you, O mighty warrior. So, pretty neat. This one, come on. I liked this one because it's in Judges, and looks like I didn't write down the verse. I'm really sorry. I apologize. I'm real bad at that. But it says, go in peace. The journey on which you go is under the eye of the Lord. So I really, really liked that one. It was pretty neat. And then I believe my next one that doesn't have a, maybe it does, is Ruth. So we all know Ruth and Naomi. Where you go, I will go. Where you lodge, I will lodge. And I traced this out of a coloring book because I just thought it was so cute. And I love Volkswagen bugs. I'm a child of the 70s. Can you tell? I just love all that stuff. Anyway, looks like this one is, I missed one. Oh, there we go. This one is kind of like what I talk about when I talk about this scrapbooking style. As you can see, I took the different bottles that have the sponges on top that we talked about. And I just polka dotted them real, you know, quick, and then laid down all my stuff with glue so it does not come out. So you got to be positive that's what you want to do. And then put down my stickers for my message, and it says, "The Lord doesn't look at the things the way you see them. Man sees the outer appearance, but the Lord looks at the heart." So I really liked that. I love the scrapbooking type stuff too. I just don't do it as much. This is 2 Chronicles 5:13 and another scrapbooking type style. It says, "He is good. His faithful love endures forever." So I love that because I love that song. We sing it at church a lot. Okay, so this one is so funny. I look back at the stuff I did at the very beginning and I was like, oh gosh, there's so much that I've learned since then. Anyway, this one is, again, I didn't write it down, but it looks like it's right here. "May we shout for joy over your salvation in the name of our God, set up our banners." So it's 25 of Psalms. So I did a banner and with the rest of it right there. So that was cool. Okay, let me see. I got to do this in order. Here we go. Our Wubba looking at everything. What is this one? Oh, okay. So I love to art journal God's Word. I believe I saw this on Pinterest. But anyway, it is Psalms 56:10. And it says, "In God whose word I praise, in the Lord whose word I praise, in God I trust, I shall not be afraid. What can man do to me?" And so I did that there. Then I'm going to skip over to my Donald and Daisy Duck at Christmas time. It says, "I will sing of the steadfast love of the Lord forever." So I did this at Christmas. Oh yeah, here's one of my teepees. Just love that. Love teepees. I don't know what it is. Okay, so this one is in Psalms 119. And again, I didn't write down the exact verse. You know what? I won't forget after this video. I'll write them down from now on. "With my whole heart, I cry, answer me, O Lord. I call to you, save me." So, and I drew my little telephone. It's so funny because my daughter was like, "Did you draw that or did you trace that?" I'm like, "No, I drew it. I drew it and spaced it out with, you know, those circles, rulers with the circles and stuff." So, yeah, I did. I was really proud of it. And this is gelato. The background is gelatos. So you can see all the different things that you can do with gelatos. This background is gelatos too, and I didn't finish it, as you can see. I was starting to do some arrows, but this is gelatos too. Just three sets put on there and then blended together. Let's see, what's this one? Oh yeah, this one's cool. This is the one that's, "Behold, children are a heritage from the Lord, like arrows of a warrior." That is in Psalms 127, 3 and 4. And then over here, it says, "I wait for the Lord, my soul waits, and in his word, I hope my soul waits for the Lord." Which I just, you know, hand wrote. And I really thought this one was pretty. I might have seen this on Pinterest. I'm not sure, but I really, really liked it. So this looks like another scrapbooking one. It says, "I praise you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made." We all know that one. I love that one. And then over here, I did a door with lips, but no evil, because it says, "Watch over the door of my lips. Do not let my heart incline to any evil." And then over here it says, "Ring, ring, O Lord, I call upon you." And this is also, this right here is also gelatos. just using it for a highlighter. Okay. This looks like this one's next. Oh, yes. So this is one of the very, this is the very first one. I did pick something off of Pinterest, and it's Proverbs 3:6, and it's the one where it says, "And he will make straight our paths." And so I did this with my very first thing I painted with my Pelican watercolors. And so I really, really like this one. And this is the one where it talks about where we get sweet sleep. It's looks like Proverbs 3:24. So, okay, so this looks like a honeycomb. Yeah, so it's one who is full loathes honey, but the one who is hungry, everything bitter is sweet. Sorry, I kept saying it looked like an eye there. So I just did, you know, honeycomb and some bees or whatever. So let me see. Where are we? Oh, yeah, I like this one. This is the Proverbs 31:30, where it says, "Charm is deceitful and beauty is vain, but a woman who fears the Lord is to be praised." That one's always really nice. This one is "The banner over me is love" on Song of Solomon. It's in chapter 2, and I want to say verse 4. Maybe it's somewhere in there, verse 4, verse 5, I don't know. Maybe verse 6, but it's right through here. Anyway, I really liked this one because I did my same little banner as I did on the other one because I liked it so much. This one is in Isaiah, and I didn't write it down again, sorry. It says, "With joy we have the wells of salvation." And I think that one is really cool. I wish I could talk more about the verses and stuff, but if I'm going to get through this, I'm not going to be able to do that. I wish I could, though. This one is in Isaiah, and it's 49:2. It says, "He made a polished arrow in his quiver. He hid me away." And then, I love my cowboy boot. And yes, I drew it. It was so hard. My daughter's like, "Fix it here, fix it there, fix it here." But how beautiful upon the mountains are the feet of him who brings good news. So that's a great verse. And I really loved my colors that I did there. And this one's "Let Your Light Shine." So I just did some hanging lanterns. Take a big jump here. Oh, this is the one that is really cool because it's the one about the deer. And it says, "I will be joyful in the God of my salvation. The Lord is my strength. He makes my feet like the deer's. He makes me tread on my high places." So I love that one. That one's cool. And then another of the talking about good news of the scrapbooking. And again, here's the camera. Love those. It says, "Go into all the world and preach the good news to everyone." So, love that. And as you see, I kind of laid down color underneath it and then put my stuff on top of it like a scrapbook. And these all letters came from the dollar store. Not all of them. Not these. These right here. These funny looking ones and the chipboard ones. He is risen. And this is Sue Carroll's design. I just love Sue Carroll. You can find her on Pinterest. She's just type in Sue Carroll, C-A-R-R-O-L-L, and she's amazing. It's Mark 16:6. She puts all these out here so people can use them to draw in their Bibles with. Oh, that's right. I did this at Christmas. This is Happy Birthday, Jesus. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you will name him Jesus. And then on the next side, I did Jesus is born. And I took this from a coloring book, so I traced it. Because I cannot draw people at all. Not in the least. It would be stick figures. So I took this off of Pinterest, and I think it was Christina's. The Lord gives us the light we need. And yeah, of course, I didn't write down the scripture. But it is in Luke 8, where Jesus feeds the 5,000. So I did a fish. And then, where are we? Oh, yeah. I did this one in honor of my brother, Rick, who served 20 years in the United States Air Force, and my son, Glenn. My son-in-law, Glenn, who is in the Army and active right now. And it says, greater love has no one than this, that someone laid down his life for his friends. And I did that in honor. It was Veterans Day or around there. It's in November. So I did that for them. I will be in a church family, the Lord's house. And I put my church, Jesus Culture Sacramento. In case no one knows that, the singing group, Jesus Culture, they have started a church in Sacramento, and I believe going to try to start more churches eventually, but it's amazing because we, you know, get to worship as our worship leader is Kim Walker Smith and Chris and the Torwaltz, and so it's really nice to go to church and them be there singing. So, love, love, love that church. Did I? Oh, okay. This is Romans. So, I was just writing about the letters of Paul to the Romans. So, did me a typewriter, and I traced that typewriter out of one of those little pages out of the Page and Tate coloring book, actually. Oh, I really liked this one. Looks like it is Romans 16:20. It says, the God of peace will crush Satan under your feet. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ will be with you. And I just love that because anytime we get to crush Satan, it's a joy. It's so awesome to put him in his place. Since that's the only thing we can put in their place. The head of every man is Christ, and the head of the woman is the man, and the head of Christ is God. That's 1 Corinthians 10 something. I didn't write it down. This one, I love this one. I think a lot of people were doing this one, and I kind of drew, tried to do myself. I have dark eyes, and I have long eyelashes, and I have a lot of curly brown hair. So I was created to create. Thank you, Lord, for my gifts. So I really, really liked that one. Looks like I'm getting through here pretty fast. I'm so proud of myself. This is 2 Corinthians 8:19. Look at that. I wrote it down. As we travel with grace for the glory of the Lord. This was when they went, Titus went traveling to spread the grace of the Lord. So it was really cool. I really liked it because I took my washi tape and I put it on my bumper. So that was kind of fun. So many things you can do with washi tape. Just love that stuff. Take it out before it rips. This one, I did see this on Pinterest and I loved it. It is Ephesians 5, 8. And it says, walk as children of light, darkness to light. So it's Ephesians 5, 8. And so I did my daughter, this is my favorite, one of my daughters, because she loves the colors, I think. And then put on the whole armor of God, which is Ephesians 6, 10. And so we talk about which one they all are. And I saw this little guy online, and I just drew him from online. I don't know which one's next. Oh, so this one's, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. And I think this is Mulan. I hope I'm not like, I think so. But anyway, I traced that out of a coloring book because there's no way I can do people. Anytime I do people, you're going to know it's because I traced it. Another camera, which I did this in my first Bible, which I talked about, but focus on God. Be an example in speech, conduct, love, faith, and purity. 1 Timothy 4, 11 through 6. Oh, and we all know this one. We have this hope as an anchor for the soul, firm and secure, in Hebrews 6, 19. And I did this with my Pelican paints. Okay, so this one is draw near to God and he will draw near to you. And I did this with watercolor, and I did this really early on, and I traced it out of a coloring book because I was like, oh my goodness, that's so cute. And I kind of messed it up, but you know, and this was before I got my Pelican paints. This was those paints from Michaels that people say are chalky, but they're not chalky. To me, I don't know. James 4:10, humble yourselves before the Lord, and he will exalt you. So I did little Charlotte's Web, and I did see this on Pinterest, but I drew it myself. And then it looks like we're at close to the last one. And this one I did because of the song by Mercy Me, Greater. It says, there will be days I lose the battle. Grace says it doesn't matter because the cross already won the war. And it's 1 John 4, 4. So he is greater. He is greater. I love this one. It's really nice. I love this one. But I love Mercy Me and all their songs. And my grandson does too. I think he's 2 and he has some of them memorized. And then the last one, it says, love one another while walking in his commands. And I don't have anything else back there. So that's pretty much it, guys. There's a lot more in here. That's not even probably half of it. But it was some of my old stuff and some of the stuff I did there at the end with my paints. So I hope you enjoyed, and stay tuned, because I think next I'm going to unpack my haul from yesterday, and then I'm going to get on to that gelatos and also tip-ins. All right. Thank you so much.